Last class we have discussed about on-off control of AC to AC converter. Today I will discuss phase control of AC to AC converter. The difference between the two control is that in on-off control, for few cycles our load is connected to source and for few cycles it is disconnected. But here in phase control, in the same cycle, or you can say positive or negative half cycle, we will connect our load with the source. Let's see. Here power flow is controlled by delaying the firing angle of the thyristor. You can see the circuit diagram. In the circuit diagram, here I have connected one thyristor and one diode, and the input voltage is AC. So in the positive half cycle, this thyristor will conduct, and in the negative half cycle, current will flow in this direction and diode one will conduct. There are some problem with this kind of circuit, that symmetrical output voltage we are not able to get unless the firing angle is 0 degree. So if the firing angle is 0 degree, then there is no use of this thyristor. You can connect diode. Our purpose is to control the power from the source to load. Here the load is resistive. Here the output voltage and current are asymmetric and consist of DC component. That means average output voltage is not zero. Some amount of DC component is drawn from the source, and because of that DC component, if it is coming from a transformer, then it may create a saturation problem across the core of the transformer. Now let's analyze the circuit. Input voltage equal to Vm sin theta. This AC voltage is Vm sin theta, and let thyristor 1 is triggered at alpha, then RMS output voltage we have to find. Now to find the RMS output voltage, let's see the waveform. Here you can see, here is our input voltage. At alpha, this angle is alpha, thyristor 1 is triggered. So output voltage will follow the input voltage. As it is a parallel connection, you can see here. Once the thyristor is on, this output voltage will be parallel to this AC input voltage. So the output voltage will follow the input voltage. So here this output voltage is following that input voltage. So here from alpha it will follow like this. Now from alpha to pi, as the load is resistive, thyristor 1 will conduct, and from pi to 2 pi, diode will conduct. So this kind of waveform you will get. So from alpha to pi you are getting the output voltage similar to the input voltage. Now at pi diode is off, then again at pi plus alpha thyristor is triggered. So again the same cycle will be repeated. You can see the same waveform. Now let's see the output current. So the output current will be in phase with the output voltage. You can see this one as the load is resistive. Now the output current will also flow from alpha to 2 pi. From alpha to pi it will flow through the thyristor number 1, and from pi to 2 pi it will flow through the diode. You can see here. So in the positive half cycle this thyristor is on, so current will flow in this direction, and the duration is from alpha to pi, as at alpha we have triggered our thyristor number 1. Now from pi to 2 pi the voltage is reversed, so the diode will get forward bias. So you can see here, so this current is negative. Then at 2 pi as the load is resistive, diode will be off. Then again at pi plus alpha thyristor will continue to conduct to 3 pi, then from 3 pi to 4 pi diode will conduct. So like this waveform you will get. So the RMS output voltage we can find from alpha to 2 pi, it is Vm sin theta. So the root mean square, you can see root, then mean is 1 by 2 pi complete time period, then alpha to 2 pi Vm square sin theta square, and it will be d theta, and you will get finally Vm by root 2 square root of 2 pi minus alpha plus sin 2 alpha by 2 divided by 2 pi. So by controlling the firing angle alpha, you can control the output voltage. This is the purpose of our AC to AC converter. Now to find the average output voltage, 1 by complete time period 2 pi alpha to 2 pi Vm sin theta d theta, and you will get Vm by 2 pi cos alpha minus 1. So average output voltage here, it is not 0 because some DC component exists in the system. Now let's see how to remove this DC component. To remove this DC component, we will replace this diode by a thyristor. So in this circuit, you can see two thyristors are connected and symmetrical output voltage you will get by applying a firing angle alpha here and at this point pi plus alpha. Let's see. Here it is, single phase controller AC to AC converter with R load. Load is resistive. The problem of DC input current can be prevented in full wave converter. If the firing angle is alpha and here it is pi plus alpha, then that average output voltage will be 0. So here again the input voltage is Vm sin theta. So this is not required here. Directly let's find the RMS output voltage because it is related with on off control. So RMS output voltage equal to, let's see the waveform first. So here you see, during positive half cycle at alpha, the thyristor number 1 is triggered and it will give the output voltage like this, and it will be equal to the input voltage. Then from pi to pi plus alpha, voltage is 0 because thyristor number 1 is off and 2 is yet not triggered, and 2 is triggered at pi plus alpha. So from pi plus alpha to 2 pi, it will follow the input voltage. You can see this one. Then again from 2 pi to 2 pi plus alpha, thyristors are off, so the voltage is 0 as current is not flowing through the circuit. Then at 2 pi plus alpha, again thyristor number 1 is triggered and it will follow the same pattern. Now let's see the output current. Output current will be in phase with the output voltage. You can see this one. So exactly same pattern of output current we are getting, similar to this output voltage. So from alpha to pi, thyristor number 1 will support the current. Then from pi to pi plus alpha, current will be 0. Then pi plus alpha to 2 pi, current will flow through the thyristor number 2. Then from 2 pi to 2 pi plus alpha, current will be 0. You can see here that at alpha, thyristor number 1 is triggered. Then at pi plus alpha, this thyristor number 2 is triggered. Then again 2 pi plus alpha, thyristor number 1 is triggered. So like this, gate pulse of thyristor number 1 and thyristor number 2 is applied. So let's find the RMS output voltage. Now to find the RMS output voltage, we can find the RMS output voltage of this one pulse, then multiply it by 2, or we can go for complete one cycle pulse from here to here. So it is 2 pi, or you can start from here to here, it is also 2 pi. So RMS output voltage equal to 1 by 2 pi multiplied by 2. Here one pulse I have taken and the pulse is from alpha to pi. You can see here from alpha to pi, so this point is pi and the voltage is Vm sin theta. So here it is Vm sin theta square. So Vm square sin square theta d theta, and you will get Vm by root 2 square root of pi minus alpha plus sin 2 alpha by 2 divided by pi. And the average output voltage here you will get 0 because positive half cycle and the negative half cycle area is equal. So the average output voltage you will get 0. So the DC component is not present across the system. So the problem of DC component is solved here. So today I have discussed about single phase AC to AC converter with one thyristor, one diode, and as well as two thyristor. In one thyristor and one diode, we have seen some amount of DC component present in the system, but in two thyristor, if symmetrically they are fired, then average output voltage will be 0 and the DC component problem is solved. In next class, I will discuss about AC to AC converter with RL load, as most of the load are inductive in nature. Similar waveform you will get as we have seen in single phase rectifier. Thank you.